Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you guys for coming out. As I've outlined in my crime plan and discussed yesterday, we are strategically deploying officers based on intelligence data and analytics and its yielding results. In partnership, the New Orleans Police Department, Louisiana State Police, FBI, Probation and Parole conducted an investigation into stolen vehicles within the 1900 block of Russia Blade Street. This investigation occurred on April 3rd, 2023. While conducting this investigation, officers observed armed individuals exiting stolen vehicles and enter a residence within that block. Working with our state and federal partners, the area was surrounded, a perimeter was set, and a search warrant was secured and executed that subsequently led to the arrest of 11 suspects. The suspects were arrested in connection with illegal possession of firearms, illegal possession of stolen vehicles, and illegal possession of narcotics. This investigation resulted in 5 stolen vehicles being recovered, 12 firearms being recovered and seized, and a large amount of marijuana and cocaine was also seized. Yesterday is an example of the crime-fighting strategies we have implemented in collaboration with our federal and state partners. Sharing this intelligence data and working together to solve crimes, targeting violent offenders, and getting firearms off the street, which in the last 3 days resulted in 22 guns being seized. I would like to thank the men and women of the New Orleans Police Department, all of our state and federal partners, LSP, FBI, and probation and parole. This was definitely a collaborative effort, and these are the kind of efforts that we've been talking about since day one, putting those strategic deployments in place and really working together, utilizing the resources that our federal and state partners have, and making the arrest that we need to work, concentrating on, having one group concentrate on removing those persons off the street who are committing these property crimes as far as vehicles as are concerned, and also getting as many weapons, illegal weapons, off the street as we possibly can. I'll take questions now. We received a subpoena, and we're going to adhere to the subpoena.
And then one actually relating to this, you know, I believe stolen vehicles are up, what, 144%? You know, can we expect more arrests and more things, more operations like this in the future?
I failed to mention this investigation is ongoing. So we're expecting it to yield more of those vehicles that were stolen. So this is not finished by far. And yes, you expect these collaborations to continue until we get that number down as far as stolen vehicles are concerned and violent crime overall.
Question. I just want to clarify, you mentioned 22 guns being seized. Now, was this the deployment plan altogether, or was it in particular to this?
The deployment plan altogether. Within the last 3 days, we've actually seized 22 guns. These guns were actually seized in the event that happened on yesterday. But a total in the last 3 days since Sunday, we've actually seized 22 guns.
The 11 suspects that were arrested, I'm assuming they might be connected to other crimes that we've been having in the area. Are you guys still investigating what?
It's still under investigation. It's unknown at this time. But again, this investigation is not complete. It's going to be ongoing. So I'm sure we'll have more information at a later date and time. But right now, those 11 suspects were arrested for those crimes that I just mentioned.
Okay, yeah, the last question over here.
Sure.
The cars, do you guys know if they were just being sold or they were going to chop shops? Did y'all found these cars?
From what I understand, these cars, they got out of some of these cars when the officers were in the area conducting conducting this investigation. So anything further, I'm not sure right now. The investigation is ongoing, so it's still going to yield some other things, I'm sure, and we'll give that information out at a later date and time.
Okay, just to clarify one thing, forgive me if I missed this. The guns were found with the cars, or is it two separate?
They, I explained that they entered a residence, a warrant was secured, and these weapons were confiscated inside that home.
Okay, last question, Andres.
Age of the suspects?
I don't have that information in front of me. We'll probably be putting that out pretty soon. We'll put out a press release, and we'll have all the detailed information on who was arrested and for what different charges.
Okay, thank you guys for coming out. We appreciate it.
Thank you.